Yo, what's going on, Dragon Ballers? Welcome back to another video. This time, we're going over the Destroyer and Angel Rares from DraftBox 5. DraftBox 5, a very controversial product. We're not quite sure how much we're getting in terms of release, and I know Bandai is working on fixing that issue. They're very aware of the issue, and I know they're working on it. But yeah, I also want to say it's very, very awesome that Bandai, again, reached out to the community. Super Players did get to do the official reveal on these cards, which is awesome. I love the fact that they reach out to the community. Doesn't have to be me. I'm glad they're able to talk to everyone in the community, all the content creators, because basically the more we all work together, the more the game grows, the better the community is, the more tight-knit it becomes, and it's overall just an awesome thing. I can't wait to see more content creators and more people get to do these types of awesome community reveals. With that being said, guys, if you're new here, make sure to subscribe, hit that bell so you don't miss a video. If you want to help support the channel, lots of ways you can do that. We've got the Patreon down below with tons of competitive content. Also helps out a lot. Also got the Crossbow TCG merch store. And finally, guys, if you want to pre-order any card you see in today's video, make sure to use my link down below to TCG Player. All that stuff helps out a lot. That being said, let's get right into this. So we've got, I'm going to totally butcher these names, by the way. I just want to get that out there. Arak and Kukatail, Universe 5, Destroyer, and Angel. I might just say Universes. Well, maybe we'll go with that. 2-drop, 16K, red-green, so they are all multicolor. Energy Exhaust, permanent. When placing this card in your energy from any area, you may choose one red card and one green card in your drop area. Send them to your warp. If you do, negate this card's Energy Exhaust skill. Okay, this is really, really cool. So there's one of each color that have this type of effect that basically get around Energy Exhaust. So I'm going to just like abbreviate that part from here on out. I'm just going to say the ignoring Energy Exhaust skill or something like that. But this is really cool. Now, is this going to be a staple like the check lands are, where it just automatically negates Energy Exhaust? Probably not, because this card does take a bit more setup than those other cards do, because you have to have the cards in your drop area, right? And not every deck can generate a drop area in the first two turns, at least with two cards in it. You know, if your leader says discard one to draw two, or if you're, you know, you have to combo things for your engine, or you have to cycle cards somehow, yeah, you can probably set this up pretty easily. But I don't think this is going to be an automatic staple like the check lands are. And even if these were just like, you know, if let's say in your deck this is an easy thing to activate, you constantly put cards in the drop area, you have the ways to use this, it's going to add a lot more 10Ks to your deck. And they do have pretty decent skills, a lot of them, which we'll talk about as we go through them. But yeah, it's going to add more 10Ks to your deck, so it can get a little clunky. But for example, this card could be really good in red-green Surge Broly, so that's something to keep in mind. Let's get on with the rest of the effect. Activate main, pay a red and a green. This card gets plus 14,000 power and double strike until the start of your next main phase. Pretty interesting. So basically, it's a 4-drop 30K double striker. Okay, not the greatest thing, but not too bad. Again, the free energy thing, especially in something like Surge Broly, where you are comboing a lot of cards to get your draw engine going, that can be pretty solid. All right, we got the Universe 8 Destroyer and Angel, Liqueur and Karoon. I really shouldn't say the names. 5-drop, 20K, critical, Energy Exhaust, Alliance. So we have not seen Alliance in quite some time. I'm going to go back over the keyword skill so you guys can get a glimpse of what it does if you haven't ever seen it before or forgot what it does. This card gains power equal to the total power of the card switched to rest mode by this skill for the battle. So basically, Alliance triggers when you attack, then you can tap any of your other red and or green battle cards, and then their power will get added to this card's power. Then when you do that, you draw two, then choose two of your opponent's battle cards to get minus 20 for the power for the turn. So that's really, really powerful. Permanent, if your leader card is red and you have a red or green battle cards in play, reduce energy cost of this card in your hand by two. So again, this card kind of just screams red, green, Broly. This is a very, very good card. But other red decks, anything that's playing red, green, like if you're playing the set, I think it's set 7 Broly, that basically goes with the whole Dormant Legend package. This could play in a lot of different things. Red, green, Gogeta BR was once a thing that could be revived from this. This card is very cool. Brings Alliance back in a cool way. I'm a pretty big fan. All right, now we got blue, yellow, Universe 1, Destroyer, and Angel. 2-drop, 16K. It has the Ignoring Energy Exhaust effect. Activate main, pay a blue and a yellow. Choose up to one of your opponent's battle cards. Place it at the bottom of the owner's deck. Thank goodness this is not bounce back to hand. We did not need any more blue cards that bounce back to hand. Then at the start of your opponent's next main phase, choose up two of your energy and switch them to active mode. Okay, pretty cool. So a 2-drop 16K that you have to play at some point, you just play it down. And then later on in the game, it's essentially a free removal piece. So what I mean by that is you have to play it at some point. It's a dinky 16K. You're probably not going to attack with it. You want it to stay on the board safely in active mode. And then later on in the game, when you need to get rid of something, you pay two, you get rid of it, but then you do get those two energy back on your opponent's turn to play defense. So in that essence, it is quote unquote free. I mean, it'll probably be most of what you're doing with that given turn, you know, paying two for the removal, but paying two for the removal of anything is pretty cool. It's a good utility effect. I think they're just trying to give these cards decent effects to have on top of being somewhat energy exhaust negating things. But this one, pretty good. I like it. It's not too bad. All right. Universe 12, Destroyer and Angel. 3-drop, 19k. Counterplay. Okay, cool. 3-drop counterplay. If the battle card being played has an energy cost of 5 or less, negate its skills for the turn and play this card. Okay, so this is a 3-drop Bloodlust that only Bloodlusts something that is 5 or less. So that's pretty interesting. I mean, for 3 energy, we have Frost Poison, which basically Bloodlust and rests anything of any cost, as long as it doesn't deflect. And keep in mind, this is in the counterplay text, so this does not get around deflect. Just so keep that in mind. Energy exhaust, Aegis, blue, yellow, once per turn. Aegis is another keyword skill we haven't seen in a little while. Aegis says you it's during your combo step defensively, you can discard either one blue yellow card or a blue and a yellow card, and then you can restand, I believe it's 2 energy. So the auto then says once per turn when you activate Aegis, draw 2. So that's pretty powerful. You get the counterplay off that if your opponent attacks, you can activate Aegis, ideally discard one blue yellow card and then draw 2. So you basically turn one card into 2 cards and get energy back. I can actually see this card being very, very good because for what it does and its value, it seems pretty solid. I'm a pretty big fan of this card. Definitely very good. Okay, so Universe 4, Destroyer, and Angel. We've got a 2-drop 20k Energy Exhaust Offering. This card is so cool. Let me tell you why. This is like the bare bones design that you could get with a card and still make it really powerful. So 2-drop 20k Offering. You play it, you either draw 2 off of it or your opponent crits a life. So basically, you can look at that in terms of like, you know, 2 mana draw 2, which is really powerful. You can also look at it as a 2-drop 20k double striker, one of which is a crit damage. Like, this is a very high value card. 2-drops are a little wonky in the current format because they are very susceptible to counterplays, whether it's Vegeta the Cruel, Preemptive Strike, Hidden Potential, Denial of Hope, whatever the case is. These cards are all kind of exposed to that. But I talked about this in a video earlier this week where if you go first, your 2-drops are generally safe because your opponent is going to charge their 1 tapped energy. You'll have your 2 open energy to play a 2-drop like this. If you go second, it's a little bit more sketchy. It's a little bit weirder, but still, it is a very, very good card in my opinion. Very, very powerful. Cool in Pan. 25k, offering, draw 1. That's pretty sweet. All right. Sidra and Mojito. I can actually pronounce those ones. Universe 9, Destroyer, and Angel. So we got a 2-drop 16k, again with the energy exhaust ignoring effect. Activate main, pay a red and a yellow. Choose one of your opponent's battle cards or energy. Switch to rest mode. Then choose up to one of your opponent's battle cards and gets minus 20,000 power for the turn. So the thing with these cards that I'm starting to realize as we're reading them is like, at some point, you got to play them for 2 and they don't really do anything. So that is the really weird part about actually hard casting these guys. But besides that, a pretty good effect here. I mean, I guess it is a total of 4 energy. That is pretty steep. But for 4 energy, you tap an energy because that's basically probably the most powerful effect you're going to use on this guy. You probably aren't going to really want to tap a battle card unless it's absolutely necessary. So you tap an energy for 4 energy, and then you minus 20 a battle card. Not the worst thing, but again, the fact that you have to actually spend energy on this guy for him to do nothing the first time you play him, it is a little rough. It is a little bit rough. All right, we're coming on to the blue-green ones. Universe 3, Destroyer, and Angel. 5-drop 25k. So those stats right there tell you that he pretty much dodges all counterplays except for like Cold Bloodlust or Frost Poison. So not too bad there for the rest of his effects. 5-drop 25k blocker, energy exhaust, revive, blue, green. So again, revive, we haven't seen it in a little while. If this card is KO'd, you can discard a blue and a green card or one blue green card and then play them from the drop area. When you play this card, choose one of your opponent's battle cards and KO it. So some pretty generic removal there. Auto, KO this card as a cost. When your opponent plays a battle card, draw 1. Pretty cool there. So like a counterplay kind of timing. You KO this guy, you activate revive, so you get him back to the board. And revive is once per turn, keep in mind. So you can't just like cycle through your deck with this. Revive is once per turn, I do believe. And then the auto draws you back a card. So you get to enter play effect again. So that's really, really cool actually, because you get the counterplay timing of KOing himself, then he comes back, then you kill something. This is another card I can definitely see being relatively good in the meta. the thing is, it is a 5 drop though, and we don't have Zenoblade anymore. So tapping 5 for this guy can be pretty costly. So I think this card's pretty good, but pretty costly. We'll see how it plays out. Then we got Universe 10 Destroyer Angel, Energy Exhaust, negates the Energy Exhaust stuff. Activate main once per turn, pay a blue and a green. Choose one of your opponent's battle cards, KO it, then draw one. Okay, 4 energy, KO something, draw one. Not too bad, not too bad in my opinion. Now we have the Beerus and Whis, Destroyer Angel. Hey, I know these guys. 4 drop 20k, blocker, invoker. If you have 3 or more energy, when one of your red or blue battle cards is removed from your battle area by an opponent's skill, play this card from your hand, and you can't play another copy for the turn. Auto, if it's your opponent's turn, when you play this card at the end of the turn, place it at the bottom of your owner's deck, then draw one. Okay, so the purpose of this card is if your Vegeta, SSB Vegeta Inspire technique gets answered, you have a temporary free invoker. So you play this for the turn, you have your invoker still alive, which is actually really cool for helping U7 recover. And then I do like how if it's the opponent's turn, you have to bottom deck this card. I like that a lot because it's just, it doesn't give them too much free real estate, which like a problem with the deck is it kind of has a lot of free real estate after turn 3 where you drop your Vegeta Inspire technique. But yeah, so it's a temporary fix, and for that reason, it's a little awkward in the deck because for one, you're banking on your card getting KO'd or removed from the board somehow, and it's only a temporary fix. So is it worth it? Maybe it's like a 2 of, but besides that, I think the card's pretty cool. Chompavados, Universe 6 Destroyer Angel, Energy Exhaust, permanent, it negates Energy Exhaust. Activate main, pay a red and a blue, return this card to the owner's hand. Choose one up to one extra card in your deck with an energy cost of 3 or more, add it to your hand, then shuffle your deck. This is interesting. This actually searches your invoker cards, but again, it costs 4 energy, kind of steep. But I can see, like, you know, on turn 2 an invoker, as long as you have your field card turn 1, you're not really doing too much on turn 2. So like, sure, maybe you play Chompavados on turn 2 and then later in the game, like turn 4 or 5, where you just have an abundance of energy, maybe you use his ability to search an extra card and then you can put it back in your energy because the TOP arena, you know, it basically tells you don't have to worry about energy exhaust anyway. Weird, but not too bad. 2 drop Hellas and Sawar, Universe 2 Destroyer Angel, has the negating energy exhaust effect. Activate main, pay a green and a yellow, choose up to 2 green or yellow battle cards in your hand that energy cost of 2 or less, play them with their skills negated for the turn, then your opponent chooses one card in their hand and places in the drop area. Okay, this card's pretty good. So for 4 energy, you get 6 energy worth of battle cards onto the board. So that's pretty good for a successor. You can go right into like a Topo after that. Well, maybe not right after that, but longer down the game line, you can go into a 6 drop successor. Maybe it can help you go into your Cell successor because Cell successor actually doesn't take energy. Secret rare specifically I'm talking about. So this card is actually really good. On top of that, make your opponent discard one. Can't ask for much more. Belmod, this card is probably the best one in the entire thing of Destruction Angel rares. So dual attack, energy exhaust, successor for 3, for 2 greens and a yellow. Auto, if you have 5 or more energy, when you play this card, your opponent chooses 3 cards in their hand and places them in the drop area. So very similar to that Cell Xeno effect. Doesn't have as much like finishing power because it's only dual attack, no double strike, no crit, no quad strike, whatever. But auto, when this card's removed from your battle area by an opponent's skill, choose any number of battle cards in your drop area with energy cost of 2 or less, for which the total adds up to 4, and then play them with their skills negated. So if they remove this, you float, which is really, really powerful. This is probably the best one in my opinion. But guys, that's gonna be all the Destruction Angel rares. Let me know in the comments below what you guys think about these cards. I think the design is really, really cool. I like what they tried to do here with the negating energy exhaust. Very, very cool. Again, guys, let me know in the comments below what you think. Thanks for watching. I will see you guys all next time.